British Boxing Blog here with Lewis Whitson. How are you doing, mate? You okay?
I'm doing good, how are you?
Nice, spot on, thank you. Cheers for having us down again.
No problem at all.
Appreciate it. So, 10 days away from a fight that's been rescheduled, what, three or four times now?
Ah, yeah, it has now. Three or four camps this year. So, get this fight over, then Viva the Blackpool this time, not Viva the Butlins, it's Viva the Blackpool.
You got
the Blackpool, eh? Got the Blackpool, aye, right, so. Got my little lip bag on, so I'm looking forward to Viva the Blackpool this time. Ready to rock.
Brilliant. I was just thinking on the way down the car there that obviously the press conference for this was February, yeah. And it was at the Sage and it was heaving and, like, you know, it felt like a totally different world and different life then. Do you know what I mean? And how's it, like, how's the whole Corona thing?
We got in the back of that great, the good performance of Robbie.
Yeah.
So got everyone interested again after the Patera. So then the place was heaving again. It was all like the city's bouncing for the boxing again, sort of thing. Then this is happening. It just sort of feels like, to be fair, on the social media, it has been, the comments have all been good, and it's all been like the Newcastle fans, like, they stick behind their own, didn't they?
Of course, the
North East, to be fair. So they've been like looking forward to it. So, but it's going to be hard with new fans there, but I suppose we've just got to get on with it.
I know. So you're going from obviously like a sellout arena to Peterborough behind closed doors. And I was speaking to you before, and it's like, obviously you want 10,000 Geordies singing your name and all that, but you were fighting at the end of the day, do you know what I mean? So you've been an amateur, you've travelled up and down the country. Does it feel?
It's just like going to be, it's like America. We were on about the other day, we went to America, we had like a gym fight over there with the kid who was fighting hooker. So we're just going to be like that, really. It's just going to be in there with 10 people there. But, you know, we dad be there, Fano Jaffa, Big Dave's going to be there. So the team's going to be there. So it's just going to be, doesn't bother us, like, to be fair, to fight a fight, isn't it?
Has it been frustrating, like, keep starting your camp, or it's been pushed back again, Lewis? You know, like, or...
Yeah, it had, but to be fair, the last couple of times, it was just before we started doing my weight cut and started making the weight, so it wasn't too bad, where we know this is definitely going ahead now. Yep. We've been given the green light for a go, so it's definitely going. We're not bored.
Look at this big rock.
Talking shit. It's good to ask you to do some work with him, I can tell, isn't he? What do you want help with?
I was going to tell you if I had six aside starting again next week.
As long as he's not asking me.
So if you want to cancel the fight.
Go
for the more important thing, six aside.
Six aside league come second or third last year?
Second.
We'll see a second just for the...
He's a player, like, nifty little...
I'm at the back. I'm like a rock at the back, aren't I?
People ask for photos in that.
Fighting every week.
Yeah. Actually, someone was working themselves.
I'm not editing this, by the way.
They were being cheeky. So Lewis said, I'll smash your head in. And the lad turned round and ran away and went, of course you will,
bastard. That was ashamed, didn't he? But he was off when he after the match. He was gone.
Where was I then? What were we talking about there?
I've lost it.
Anyway, the postponed, getting postponed and all that, but do you feel lucky in a way that, like, there's a lot of good British fighters out there who still haven't had a fight this year and who, you know, like your Callum Smiths, people like that, like, whose career sort of going nowhere, at least you've, well, not going nowhere, but at least you've had something to focus on and you actually have got a fight, do you know what I mean? Because there's a lot of good fighters out there.
Yeah, it would be hard not going, getting out for, like, well, then you're leading the next year and then you don't know still what's going to happen with lockdown, so it could be, like, a year and a half or 2 years before you even get out, some of them. So we managed to get out, lucky us in October and get a fight, at least we'll get one this year and not have to wait till next.
It's been like a year since Robbie Davis now. Is that like mad pay-wise, like financially wise, thinking, because you're a boxer, you get paid when you fight, you know what I mean?
Look, I'm like sensible with me when you mean, so I don't need to fight for the next couple, I'd be I was going to be sensible with my money and be sound, so just being sensible, isn't it? And obviously, well, I like to get paid at the end of the day, so hopefully this definitely does happen. I'm going to get some more money in the bank, so treat little legs a bit. So, but it is what it is. I think the whole, like you say, every boxer's went through it, haven't they? They've got to go through it, and someone's going to be lucky enough to get a fight, so we're going to be lucky enough to have one and get paid.
And Vasquez has been there throughout. He's always been the opponent. He's never changed. Like, he's obviously up for himself. And
he's done his interview the other day, didn't he? He looks like he's up for it and he's ready to come, so... and this is his last chance, isn't it, really? I always said so, his last big chance, so I'm expecting the best Vasquez, but he's going to have to see the best of me.
And that's the direction you're going in now, isn't it? You know, you see a few people either fighters call your name or people on social media saying, oh, what about Horry Davis? What about Akeem Ennis-Brown? But for you, it's that would be a sort of step back.
I'm glad you said that. Like, Abhi Vasquez had to step back. Like, Vasquez beat a Horry, didn't he? Like, everyone,
no, that's true.
He didn't get it on, but everyone knows he won. And like, we're ranked with the WBA a lot higher than all them. So why would I beat someone like Vasquez, then go back and fight for like a British title that I've already got one for keeps in the house? So it doesn't make any difference. And like I say, like you said, they're a bit of a backward step, really. Well, that's in all my opinion and the opinion in the gym. So,
because I guess you've done that. You've done the whole British grudge match, Bobby Davis. Why go back to like?
Yeah, and
do
even
you know what
the,
I mean?
The grudge match, yeah, I just won the European title the fight before me.
Yeah.
You know, we just didn't defend it in time to have it on the line for the fight. So, like, you know, even that fight was a domestic, but it was like past domestic level. Do you know what I mean? It was like European level. So, I've won class, proved I'm European level. Now I'm trying to prove that on fringe world level, beat Vasquez, and then you are, then you get a fight with a fighter that is world level.
Do you look beyond that? I've heard obviously Progray's mentioned Eddie Hearn.
I'm not even looking into it. You know, like I was looking there before the after Robbie Davis, thinking Josh Taylor was going to be the one at St James's Park and getting ahead of myself about that, and now come of it. So the days are getting ahead of fights and all that. And even before the terror, getting ahead of myself before that, and thinking I was going to do this and going to do that. Just learning the hard way with that. So just keep focused on one fight at a time.
Do you feel like a 140-pound fighter now? Because I remember speaking to you after Davis and you were like, if there's just something between 135 and 140, I'd be an absolute monster. But
no, I think it's given us enough time this year that to like fit in it the way I had three fights in it last year. Now I feel as though even though I haven't had a fight this year, I've built myself into the weight now, and I'm a bit like on my 3D scans at the where we do with strength and condition, like the best body rating I've had, the best muscle mass and all that. So like this year really has given us a good time to like build into the weight, and like I'm not a smaller 140-pounder if you get a good look. So no, I think we definitely are 140. Look at these, man. Look at him, he's laughing. You'll have to get a body shot on you one of these days.
Jesus, I will. I again, he's completely killed us there. So 10 days out. I guess you're going into that bubble, as they like to call it, next week down Peterborough.
Yeah, bubble on the Tuesday. Got the COVID test 12, so we've got to get there early then. Just that's just where I used to, you know, make the way in the big heater, making it easy for them, that. So we've got to go down there and just do it differently. So we'll be fit and strong in the night, and we'll just, me and Tommy, ready to put in two good performances.
So we are having quite a, like a northeast build, you know, and it was obviously meant
like
to be the arena.
Build, but down the country, isn't
aye,
it?
Down
you
the
know,
country,
like, so it's good for the northeast that they've kept it. Kept their own North East bound, and then the four fighters that are on it, so be good in there. Hopefully Svan Elvin, her fight, we'll have a world champion up here.
Absolutely, aye. Just one more, just obviously looking back like we were before, that it's actually 3 years ago today since you beat Robbie Barrett for the British lightweight title, and I guess that's the fight that started it all, really. Do you know what I mean? You went down there as the underdog, won that, and then everything that came after that. So how do you look back on that 3 years?
Now just take the chance, isn't it? Like,
yeah.
You know, just take the chance and look where we are now. Like, I was speaking off camera, it's going to be with 12th fight in Sky now, you know, like since then. So
I still feel that meant
on me. No, it's mad. And aye, just like feel like a bit of a veteran now, around 27, but just there or thereabouts, aren't we? So, but like I said, just get the chance and taking it. And we did that, and we're still going strong, and plenty more nights to come.
Plenty more nights in Newcastle, hopefully, next year.
Aye, hopefully, things, you know, like wherever the title we're fighting, that's where we're fighting there. Now I've got Big Neil trainers, and I've like said it a few times, I think Big Neil's the best trainer in the country, so he'll get us ready for these big fights. And I think me, Tommy and Savannah, I've said it before, we'll have three world champions in the North East by this time next year.
Absolutely, mate. Thank you very much. Appreciate your time. So close to fight night as well. Thank you.